Heavenly Father, we want to thank you this morning. We want to thank you for life. We want to thank you, Lord, for everything that you have done for us during this week and what you are going to do for us for the rest of the week. I thank you, dear Lord, Father, for every listening ear this morning. And I pray, Almighty God, that as my word go out, that someone will be blessed. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, my Lord and my Savior. Bless each person on the platform. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. My scripture reading for today is taken from, it's a familiar passage. It's taken from Matthew 11, verses 28 to 30, and it's taken from the New Living Translation version. Matthew 11, 28 to 30, verses 28 to 30, and it reads thus: Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. And the title of my devotion is Accept This Invitation. In this scripture, Jesus has made an invitation to those who will hear him. He has the power to reveal the Father to whomever he chooses. Then he offered to all who are weary and burdened the opportunity to come to him and find rest and to be yoked with him. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, is an invitation for the broken-hearted and burdened sinner. Jesus is saying, come just as you are. I will give you rest. This promise of rest that Jesus offers is a rest that he freely gives to all who will come to him for salvation. The rest that Christ gives is an eternal rest beyond our understanding that can never be earned or purchased. The rest he offers is freely available as God's gift of grace to whosoever will come. Accept this invitation. In this dark and evil society, each person encounters different pressures and suffering, not knowing how to cope. Jesus' desire for us, the weary and burdened, is to come to him and lay our burdens on him. He promises to comfort us and provide us with strength so that we can find rest in him. Accept this invitation. If you are tired and struggling, Jesus can give you rest. Accept this invitation. Jesus is the wellspring of life and the light that has come into the world to give hope to all who will trust in his name for salvation. And his invitation to come is for whoever will. Christ alone is the one who can heal the hurting, rescue the perishing, and save a sinner from eternal separation from our Heavenly Father. For there is no other name given among men whereby we must be saved. Acts chapter 4, verse 12 says, there is salvation in no one else. God has given no other name under heaven by which we must be saved. Following Jesus frees us from carrying the burden of our own sin because he has already done that work. All we need to do is put our faith, hope, and trust in him. Jesus is reassuring us that we are not alone. When we hand over everything to him and allow the Holy Spirit to take charge, he will take care of the rest. There is no rest in any other than in the rest and peace Christ promises. Accept this invitation. Jesus wants to offer rest for the souls of all who are weighed down and weary. We don't have to carry our burden alone. Jesus is always willing and ready to carry our burden. accept this invitation. This kind of rest is soul rest. It's a way for us to have rest in our minds and in our emotions. This is the rest that Jesus is offering. Accept this invitation. How can we find rest in the Lord? Psalm 37, verse 7 says, "Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him." Rest in the Lord is an often used expression in the Bible. When the psalmist says, "Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him," he's not talking about physical rest that involves taking a break from activity, relaxing, napping, or stopping to gather strength to continue or complete some physical undertaking. Rest in the Lord refers to a spiritual rest from confusion, worry, distraction, and to be at peace, to be quiet or calm in the presence of the Lord. We can experience true rest when we spend time in God's presence. The Bible says, "Be still and know that I am God," Psalm 46:10. So don't carry the load alone. Jesus is inviting you. He is inviting me to rest in him and allow him to work in us. Accept this invitation. Verse 29 goes on to say, "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle in heart." What is a yoke? A yoke is a wooden beam that was used between a pair of oxen or other animals to enable them to pull together on a load when working in pairs. When Jesus preached, he used metaphors and illustrations ordinary people could relate to. So it is in the natural, so it is in the spiritual. Jesus compares his yoke to this equipment that connects animals together to pull a load, which could be difficult and burdensome to keep. Jesus is saying his yoke, however, is easy and his burden is light. Jesus does not want to add to our burden. Instead, he wants us to learn from him and give him control over our situation. The heavy yoke of bondage to sin is a weighty burden we all have to carry on the treadmill of life, which causes physical weariness, spiritual fatigue, and emotional exhaustion. But Christ's invitation, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened," brings rest to the weary, comfort for the hurting, solace to the heavily burdened, and rest for our soul. Accept this invitation. Jesus is saying to us to take up his yoke instead. In other words, Jesus is saying to us, "You are under a yoke which makes you weary. Shake that off and try mine, which is easy to carry." He wants to exchange our yoke for his. He wants to remove the load from us and give us peace. Accept this invitation. To take Christ's yoke upon us is to obey the gospel of Christ and to yield ourselves to him. In the same way, when we go through life without God's guidance, we are of almost miserable. 1 Corinthians 15:19 says, "And if our hope in Christ is only for this life, we are more to be pitied than anyone in the world." By accepting Jesus' yoke instead, we allow him to walk with us and share the load. Taking Jesus' yoke doesn't mean holding on to the things that weigh us down, like unforgiveness, bitterness, and shame. Instead, taking his yoke gives us freedom from these things as we humble ourselves before him. 1 Peter 5, verse 6 to 7 says, "Humble yourself, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. Cast all your cares upon him, because he cares for you." Taking Jesus' yoke means to enter into submission to his will, to turn over control of one's life to him, laying down what is pressing us down, our fears, our worries. Jesus gives the reason why we should take his yoke upon us and learn from him. He said, "For I am gentle and humble in heart." Jesus explains his character, his meekness, his humility. Living a Christian life is not without challenges. There will be difficulties, sacrifices, and commitment to living according to God's will. However, Jesus assures us we don't have to shoulder this burden alone. Jesus said, "In this world, you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." John 16:33. So Jesus knew we would face trouble. So he welcomes our reliance on him. Sometimes God allows things to happen in our lives that seem too heavy, and we begin to lose hope and sometimes even question ourselves and ask, "What have I done wrong?" But the good news is that we can be comforted by the promises that God has made in his word. Such scriptures as Psalm 55:22. "Cast your burden on the Lord, and he shall sustain you. He shall never permit the righteous to be moved." God is glad to carry our burden and give us daily strength as we need. Accept this invitation. It is not God's will that we should be crushed down with excessive burden. So let the Lord free you today. Isaiah 58:6. "Is this not the fast that I have chosen, to loose the bonds of wickedness, to undo the heavy burden, to let the oppressed go free, and that you break every yoke?" So are you burdened today? Is your load uneasy to bear? Jesus is extending this invitation. Will you accept it? We don't have to carry the burden alone. We can rely on all the promises that Jesus has given us in his word. He promises to support and help us through every trial. He is waiting to give us rest. Rest for our souls, rest in our minds. Accept this invitation. The invitation to come is from Jesus. It's from Jesus, and it contains no limitations or restrictions. He will turn no one away. There is no need to stand afar off, because Christ calls all to draw close to him. He alone can lift the heavy yoke of bondage to sin, which weighs down the burdened heart. He alone can heal the brokenhearted, rescue those that are perishing, and set the captive free from the heavy burden of sin. And his invitation is open to all who will believe on his name. Accept this invitation. Jesus gives love, peace, healing, and one day eternal life and joyful unity with him. So will you accept this invitation today? Let us pray. Most Heavenly Father, we thank you that your yoke is easy and your burden is light. Thank you for the promise you give that we should not worry. Thank you that you can ease our burden when we come to you. Thank you that you already know all our concern, all that concern us, and that you care. And we are so grateful for your reminder that we don't have to carry our burden all on our own. Forgive us for the times that we try to fix things on our own, in our own power, for not taking the time to rest, or coming to you with our needs and our burdens. Thank you for the refreshing that comes from your spirit, filling us with joy, covering us with a shield, and leading us forward with hope. Equip us to be those who take notice of others who seem weary and burdened, and help us to slow down, to take the time to point others to you. We ask all this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Praise be unto God. Have a blessed day, everyone. I love you.